Welcome to this wonderful groundbreaking today for the Catonsville District Courthouse. I'd like to recognize a number of distinguished guests that we have here with us today. Of course, we have the Lieutenant Governor, Lord Rutherford. We have from the District Court, Chief Judge Dr. Morrissey, and we have Administrative Judge Dorothy Wilson. Also, I saw that we have Delegate Charles Sidner here with us today. And we have our two architects, Frank Green with Ricky Green Art Associates and Brent Freight of Bushy Freight Warren Architects. And of course, we have our contractor, David Costello with Costello Construction Group. The skies have opened and it's a beautiful day for a groundbreaking. And we're proud at General Services to be the stewards of the state facilities. We play a central role in the design and construction of new facilities across the state. The Maryland Judiciary is a great client. We love having the Judiciary as our client, and our team is working closely to design the new courthouse that meets the needs and citizens of Maryland. We will be overseeing the construction, and when complete, in 2019, we will have a modern, accessible, customer, and eco-friendly facility that will have convenient on-site parking and will feature state-of-the-art technology and security. So I'd like to invite Chief Judge of the Maryland Court of Appeals, the Honorable Barbera.
Thank you, Secretary Churchill. It is indeed a great day. Today is a day of celebration and renewal as we break ground on a new courthouse for the District Court here in Catonsville. The day is long awaited. Planning for the new courthouse began, 15 years ago. It may even have been, I think I heard Judge Williams say, maybe 20 years ago. The need to replace an antiquated facility was clear. The need for more courtroom capacity was clear. The need for facilities to deliver services that are needed by those accessing the District Court here in Baltimore County was clear. But there were challenges. Finding a parcel of land, as Secretary Churchill mentioned, with a mandated address within Catonsville, within the 21228 zip code, was quite a challenge. Just as challenging was finding a place for the project among the many, and I emphasize many, compelling and competing capital improvement needs across Maryland. I think I have perhaps a small idea of the enormity of what the governor's office and with your help, Secretary Churchill, have to do to manage it all. Thank you for looking the judiciary's way. You've heard me in the past perhaps paraphrase Supreme Court Justice Thurgood Marshall, who noted that the mere access to the courthouse door is not enough. Access to justice is far more than that. It is what is obtained when the doors open wide for all Marylanders, no matter who they are, to obtain a fair and prompt resolution of their issue, whether it's at the clerk's counter or in a courtroom, and to all who work together, pulled together with the judiciary to find the resources for this new Catonsville courthouse. Because of your support, new doors will be here to open wide in Catonsville to welcome all who seek justice. So with that, Chief Judge Morrissey, I'm sure you have a few comments.
Thank you, Chief. Good morning, everyone. Thank you for joining us for this exciting and rare moment for the District Court of Maryland. The planning and preparation for this courthouse has been a long time coming, but it's all been worth it to finally be moving dirt and getting the ball rolling on this beautiful new building. The new Catonsville Courthouse is not only a desire, but a necessity. The current building that houses the District Court here in Catonsville long ago exceeded its functional capability to ensure the efficient delivery of justice to Marylanders and to, importantly, keep our employees and the public safe. The new building will house 8 courtrooms, double the number of what the current courthouse has, and it will incorporate state-of-the-art security. This new facility was designed to be environmentally friendly. It'll be a LEED Silver at a minimum and have a green roof. I think it's the first building that the Department of Governmental Services has that will have a green roof. And I'm planning on planting tomatoes, cucumbers, and jalapeno peppers on the roof. In addition, we'll also have a parking lot that will be able to accommodate all the visitors that come, both our clients as well as our employees and judges right here on this property. I'd like to thank you, Lieutenant Governor Rutherford, as well as Governor Hogan, for your support and understanding of this important new courthouse. I'd also like to thank you, Chief Judge Barbera, for making this courthouse a priority in your budget over her own demonstrated needs for her own facility. So thank you, Chief. I must also acknowledge former Chief Judge Bell, as well as my immediate predecessor, Chief Judge Clyburn, and former Administrative Judge Sandy Williams. Well, I'm going to take all the credit for this new courthouse. It was those three that had the vision and perseverance to make possibility a reality. I'd also like to thank the Department of Governmental Services, and in particular Barry Miller, for being the judiciary's architect extraordinaire. I'd also like to thank my chief clerk, Bobby Wernkin, who advised me that being environmentally conscious made a lot more sense than having a helipad on the roof of this new building. The tomatoes never would have survived anyway, right? There are many others, both inside and outside the judiciary, that made this project work, and to you, I thank you. I look forward to working with our justice partners as well as our neighbors in this community. The new facility will allow our citizens to have centrally located services and will provide space for our state's attorneys, the Office of the Public Defender, and one of the projects that I'm most proud of, the District Court Self-Help Center. It will serve the citizens of Baltimore County as well as points north from here. The district court had its genesis from what was called the People's Court. It's the first and sometimes only court in which a citizen comes in contact with the judicial system here in Maryland. When the district court was created in 1971, trials were held in mechanics garages, old retail establishments, and even a butcher shop. It really is amazing to see how far we've come in less than 50 years.
Well, it's my honor now to introduce the Lieutenant Governor, Roy K. Rutherford. He has a lifetime of experience in both the public and private sector. He has an extensive legal and business background. And I'm not going to go through his resume, but the departments that he has served under over his time is extensive, including the U.S. General Services Administration, the U.S. Department of Agriculture, and of course, he was the Secretary of General Services under Governor Bob Earl. I liken the Lieutenant Governor to E.F. Hutt. When he speaks, of course, I do listen. In the first 10 minutes of being here, I did hear Lieutenant Governor remark to the contractor, there will be no change orders. His leadership has been great in terms of changing Maryland for the better. So it is my privilege to introduce the Honorable Lieutenant Governor, Roy K. Rutherford.
Thank you, Secretary Churchill. We were just talking about the long history associated with bringing this courthouse to this point. And I was trying to remember, and I think Nelson Riker will remember better, but when I was in General Services, which was over 10 years ago, we were talking about the challenges associated with bringing on board a new courthouse here. And trying to remember all the machinations, which I didn't remember, but I know there were various issues associated with the location, with the prior location. I think UNBC was involved or interested at some point. There was just a number of challenges that have been overcome in the last several years. And so, glad to be here. You know, thank you for everyone being here. I hope I'm not the only one who's cold, because it is a little chilly out here. I want to thank again Judge Barbera, Judge Morrissey, and Administrative Judge Wilson. Thank you for joining us here this morning. You know, since day one of our administration, the Governor and I have focused on economic development and making sure that we grow the private sector, create jobs, and turn our economy around. And since January of 2015, we've been doing that. Recently, U.S. News and World Report, in an issuance or a survey of the top states in the country, ranking 68 different categories, including health care, education, government, economy, crime, among others, and compiling that data to rank the best places in the country, best states in the country to live. I'm proud to report that Maryland beat out 42 other states and is now ranked number 8 in terms of best states in the United States to live. It, in 2015, it was the best year in 15 years for Maryland businesses, and our overall economy now ranks in the top 10 amongst the 50 states. We've added more than 73,000 jobs, and we've lowered the unemployment rate to 4.2%. And as we like to say, Maryland is truly open for business. And that's been incredible progress in the 2 years moving forward as we continue to grow the economy. And that's why I'm very pleased to be here today to celebrate this groundbreaking of the new Catonsville Courthouse, which represents even more economic development and job growth. We'll have 35 contractors and suppliers on this project, including 13 minority business enterprises will be involved. We'll have over 40 workers engaged in the construction, and Mr. Costello is here, our general contractor, who, as he reminded me, and I concurred, he's had a long and wonderful history with DGS, Department of General Services, in providing construction support for us over the last several years. Equally as important, what this project means to the judicial system, which is a cornerstone of our American democracy, is tremendous. From the early days of our nation, the American judicial system has played a major role in defining and preserving freedom, equality, and justice. The design of the new courthouse expresses that solemn, dignified, and accessible nature we strive for in our court system. As was mentioned before, the District Court of Maryland doesn't have a particularly long history. Created in 1971, as Judge Morrissey said, it's not quite 50 years old. Our Court of Special Appeals is not much older than that, only established 5 years earlier in 1966. And as lawyers, including myself, appreciate the significant role of the court system plays in preserving and protecting our democratic principles, we are all appreciative of what it provides and what the judges and those jurors provide. I have no doubt that the Catonsville Courthouse will be the courthouse for the 21st century. Its technology will be state of the art. Security measures in the buildings and the building's layout reflect the heightened importance we place on the safety of our employees, the building, and the citizens that will be entering the facility. And as was mentioned, it will be the first courthouse in Maryland to have a green roof, an eco-bio-retention facility, as well as reforestation, representing important steps taken to protect our environment. I have no doubt that you will be proud of this new facility, and I look forward to coming back to see it after construction is completed, and possibly during construction, if Mr. Costello would allow it. So congratulations to everyone on this important occasion and on this very important project. Thank you for having me here today.
All right.
Thank you.